Hello students, today we are going to study a very interesting chapter of geography, that is the interior of the earth. Have you ever wondered what lies below the surface of the earth? Is there rock or something liquid? Today we'll study the interior of the earth, that is what is inside the surface of the earth. Earth was formed around 5 billion years ago. At that time, Earth was a molten ball of rock. When it cooled down, the heavy material sank down while the lighter material floated up. We can relate the interior of the earth like an onion, with several layers, one inside the other. The earth is made up of three main layers: the crust, the mantle, and the core. Crust is a thin outermost layer. The innermost part is called the core, while the part between the crust and the core is the mantle. There is an increase in temperature, pressure, and density as we move from the surface to the interior of the earth. Let us discuss each of the layers of the earth in detail. The crust is the uppermost layer of the earth. It is the thinnest among the three layers. The crust is just 1% of the volume of the earth. The crust itself has two layers, the upper crust and the lower crust. The upper crust is known as Sial. It is mainly consists of minerals like silica and aluminium. The lower crust made up of the ocean floor. It is a continuous layer of denser rock. The lower crust is also known as sima. It is made up of minerals, silica, iron, and magnesium. The thickness of the upper crust that makes up the continent is around 35 to 70 kilometers, while the thickness of the lower crust that makes up the oceans is around 5 to 7 kilometers. The next layer of the earth is the mantle. The layer just below the crust is the mantle. It is approximately 2900 km thick. The mantle is further divided into two layers, the upper mantle and the lower mantle. The upper mantle is a thin, stiff layer. It is mainly made up of minerals, silica, iron, and magnesium. From the bottom of the crust, it has a depth of around 300 km. When the upper mantle ends, the lower mantle extends. It is around 300 kilometers to 2900 kilometers. The temperature here is very high. It is about 3000 degrees Celsius. In the lower mantle, the material is semi-solid. The molten material in the lower mantle is called magma. The magma flows out as a lava during the volcanic eruptions. The third and the innermost layer of the earth is the core. The core is further divided into the upper core and the inner core. The depth or the radius of the core is about 3500 km. The upper core is 2300 km thick and the inner core is about 1200 km thick. The upper core is hot and molten, that is liquid core. The lower core is hotter than the upper core, but it is under extreme pressure, so it remains solid. The temperature in the core is hotter than It is hotter than the sun's surface. Now let us understand the crust, the mantle and the core with the help of the diagram given in our book. In the diagram, the thin line represents this thin line, the black line. The thin line represents the crust. The crust under the continent is 35 to 70 km, while under the ocean it is 5 to 10 km. The orange, the light orange and dark orange portion of the diagram represents the mantle. It extends to 2900 kilometers. The light orange portion represents the upper mantle, while the dark orange represents the lower mantle, where the mantle ends, the core starts. The core extends to about 3500 kilometers. The upper core is 2300 kilometers, while and the inner core is 1200 kilometers.